Ladies and gentlemen, welcome here to the technical forum at the group exhibit Hydrogen Fuel Cells, and for the first time this year in Hannover with batteries. Come in, have a seat, have a free drink, and enjoy with me our next presentation dealing with the topic bipolar plate and gasket production for PEMF fuel cells. And your presenter will be Christoph Demwolf from the company Eisenhut. Give him a big hand, please.
Hello, I welcome you to my presentation about our activities through bipolar plates and gaskets. My name is Christoph Demwolf, and I am working for Eisenhut since the beginning of this year. So I would give you an overview about our company. We have three main different divisions. The first division is about mold building, for example, for the automotive industry. The second main division deals with the production of small and medium sized rubber and plastic parts. And the reason because I'm standing here today is our third division, which was established in our company in 2007. It's about, you can see, bipolar plates and batteries. The supply chain is divided in three parts. The first part is about the CAD construction. There we use the program CATIR 5. And yes, after construction, we use the states to develop a machine language called CAM. And this is used to build molds for example, injection and compression molding. Right, you can see in the third stage. Now I come to the bipolar production. We also make our compounds by ourselves. There we use extrusion machine. You can see on the picture, the two pictures on the left. The compound is a compound of graphite and plastic in different variations. Afterwards, we have the possibility to make the bipolar plates by compression molding and injection molding, or by pressing blank plates and then milling the flow field structure. This goes by injection molding, and afterwards we can integrate the gaskets to the bipolar plates. You can see on the picture on the right, and afterwards it goes to our quality control, where we have different opportunities to control our products. I show you later. That's something difficult to make bipolar plates by injection molding. But we make good experience by this in to create bipolar plates with a big size and a thickness, which is very low. Yeah, that's so integrated bipolar plate with gasket. Yeah, we have some wishes from our customers to our products. They deliver us the geometry of the bipolar plates, and we try make injection or we make a compression molding by building a mold up to 200 plates because of cost reasons. Yes, there are high tolerances, for example, in the fuel cell technology, and yeah, we have a lot of effort to achieve this high tolerances. Yeah, and injection molding is for high volume production. I told you about our compound material. There we do it by ourselves because of the reason which are shown there on the slide. Yeah, and it's the main reason is to reduce the cost and to achieve better electric conductivity, because there are great cost reduction potentials for fuel cells. Also, we develop bipolar plates for the redox flow technology and electrolyzers. In the quality control, we have a lot of measurements. On the left side, you can see some microscopes, and on the right side there is a application to prove the through plane electric conductivity. In the in-plane conductivity there is more effort to achieve this, but we also can achieve it. For other application, for example, redox flow technology, it's important the permeability of the plates. So we weight every plate to get an impression of the permeability. On the other picture on the right shows a pressure test application. It's to detect some scratches or something like that. We can produce gaskets in small units. For example, if some customer has a question or have one prototype, we can produce a small series from 1 to 10. Or something like else, and with this laser technology, also we make a gravure on the bipolar plates to characterize the plates. There is another application for bipolar plates and the fuel cell. We have developed. A transporter. Yes, you can see it. It's on a golf field, and it's so we can achieve. There are our customers. I can perhaps you can know Zellstrom. Zellstrom is a big manufacturer of vanadium redox flow batteries in Austria, and for example, the other in-house and Truma, they develop PEM fuel cells for high temperature or low temperature. Yeah, and we have we are involved in two European projects founded by the hydrogen and fuel cell joint adventure. One project is Eureka. There we try to develop a middle temperature PEM fuel cell. We develop a new mirror, bipolar plates, and that goes to a new stack design. And there is a company called Inhouse who integrates who makes a system integration. The other project is System. It's also a micro CHP system, but it's not especially for private households. It's more for little village to get them independent from other energy sources. Yeah, thank you for my presentation.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Dempfer, for this interesting presentation. So, are here any questions right now? Not yet, from the audience. Okay, John, in other case, and maybe your questions come a little bit later on your mind, you have a booth here at the group exhibit. It's right here, and I see some leaflets and brochures, so everyone can inform their self, and you and your colleagues are here whole day. So if you are just to discuss anything, please go straight ahead. Yeah. Thank you very much, Mr. Dempfer. So after a short break, just about a quarter hour, we will continue our program here with a presentation from the company Decode. And it deals with the topic online diagnostic of PEMFC by electrochemical spectroscopy thanks to the power converter. Thank you for staying.